channel, the Appalachian Home. So today in this video, we're going to be going over how to use Cricut's print then cut feature. And I use this feature all the time on my machine. I use it for labels for my products. I also use it just for simple tags to label my files and things like that. You can print all sorts of neat little labels and stickers. I use it for stickers also. I love making stickers. So I'm going to be showing you how to do a simple label using the print and cut feature and how to cut that out. So I hope you enjoy today's video. So first, when you're in Design Space, you want to go ahead and open a new project. Today I'm going to design a round label. So first I'm going to hit the circle icon. Next you want to change the size of your circle. Mine is going to be 2.5 inches, and you just want to make sure that the lock is closed. Now I want to change the color, and you can do this under the color box. And I want mine to look like brown craft paper, so I'm changing it to brown. Next, you just want to add your text, and mine's going to say strawberry jam. And I'm changing my font to a font called Better Together. And I'm adjusting my font up here at the letter spacing. And you can also ungroup all of your text and adjust the letters one by one until your letters look exactly the way you want them to look. You can also upload images to print and cut, just like you would for a cut file. And then you can just resize it to whatever size that works on your label. Then you just play around until you're happy with your design. Now at the top of your screen, you want to go to Fill, and you want to make sure all of your images and texts are changed to print. So now I'm just going to duplicate these labels to fill up my sheet. And Cricut Design Space has a print and cut area that is 6.75 by 9.25. So I'm going to go ahead and draw a square that is that size, 6.75 wide by 9.25 long. And that way I can just fit all my labels inside that, and I will know how many labels that I can actually print out. So I can fit 6 2.5 inch labels on one print and cut area, and you can go up to the top of your screen and align these to the left side or to the top so that everything is aligned and evenly spaced. And once you have your labels designed the way you want them and evenly spaced, I'm going to go ahead and erase the square box that I drew for my print and cut area. Next, you want to drag a box around all of your labels to select everything. And once everything is selected, I want to go to the bottom right hand side of my screen and click the icon that says flatten. And what this flatten icon does is flattens all the text onto your labels. So it will not cut out your letters, it will only cut out the circles around your letters. Using white sticker paper. I believe I got this from Online Labels. I'll try to link it down below. Once you have your labels printed, then you can just go ahead and place it onto your mat. And I'm using a light grip mat so that it doesn't tear my paper. And I'm just placing the corner at the corner of the grid. For the material setting, I'm using removable sticker paper. That way it's just going to kiss cut through the top of the sticker and not through the backing. So you can use print and cut for literally anything you want to print and cut out for labels. I even use it for product labels. So just go ahead and play around with your machine. Have fun with it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you're not subscribed, I hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel. And I'll see you guys next time.